Okay, I like the way this class diagram is coming along. So at this point, I think we have all the classes that we need. For each class, we specify the attributes, so the characteristics of the class, and we also specify the operations, so we know what the class can do. And I'd like to kind of move forward on this, but I first want to see whether you're fine with the class structure. So that's the way the class structure is going to be in terms of attributes and operations. So anything that bothers you?
Well, one thing I didn't understand is how come you put checkout over with the patron when it's really the item that's being checked out?
Right. Okay. So that actually, it's a perfect segue for the next thing that I really wanted to model. Because what you're talking about is basically a relationship between two classes, which is something that we haven't touched on yet. So we have looked at the individual classes, but now it's just typical, right? We're looking more at the requirements. We're starting to find more things about our system. And what you're pointing out right now is the fact that patron and item are somehow related. So this checkout operation is not really something that belongs only in the patron, because it needs to know about the item, and doesn't belong only in the item because it needs to know about the patron. So it's something that associates the patron and the item.
Okay.
And that's exactly the way we call in a UML, which is the notation that we're using here, this kind of relationship. So we're going to represent that by drawing a line between these two classes that tells us that there is an association. And we're also going to give a name to this. Since this refers to the fact of checking out items, we're just going to call it checkout.
Gotcha.
And notice that this basically, eventually will end up, kind of replacing this attribute, because the existence of this association will tell us that this is checked out. We're not going to, do it right now, but in the final cleanup of the diagram, this thing will disappear.
Okay.
Okay? And so since we started talking about relationships and associations, is there any other kind of relationship that you see here?
Well, what you just did with checked out is seems similar to the whole issue of requests.
It is. It is. So a request is something else that happens both, in the patron and in the item, right? It involves both. And in fact, request, I will definitely represent this as an additional association. So I will just draw another line between these two that represent that specific kind of relationship, and I will call it request. So that indicates that this association refers to a request that also connects a patron with an item.
Okay.
And let's see, anything else that jumps at you?
Yeah, well, how about all these ones down at the bottom? I mean, book and item has got to be related, right? A book is a kind of item, and audiovisual, are there associations between them?
Can you repeat that? You said that the book
is a kind of item.
Perfect. That's exactly what we're modeling next, which is this what we call the ISA relationship. So you said a book is an item. A book is an item. And we can model that in the diagram. So we do that using another kind of relationship between the classes. So we're going to represent that as a specialization, we call it. And the specialization is indicated in this way. Okay, with this arrow at the end, so a solid line with this kind of arrow at the end. And we can do the same for book, magazine, reference book, and audio video material. So we're gonna connect all of them to the item using the same kind of connection. And now that we have connected all these four with item and indicated them as subclasses, that's something else that we can do. So we can make this kind of a cleaner. And I'll tell you what I mean by that. So now we have this loanable attribute that refers to item. But it seems to me from what you were saying before that loanable is not really an attribute of an item, right? It's more a characteristic of the type of item.
Right.
Is that right?
Right. Books and audiovisual are loanable, but the others aren't.
Okay. So representing it here, I mean, it's okay. So it will work, but it's not really right. So from a, from the style standpoint, it doesn't really... it's not the best way of modeling this. What we're going to do instead, we're going to use this specialization relationship to make that more explicit, to make it cleaner. Okay, so what I'm doing here is that I'm going to take this hierarchy of classes that is just on two levels now, and I'm going to kind of make it a little richer. So I'm going to add an intermediate set of classes. In particular, I'm going to have these two classes that I'm going to call non-loanable item and loanable item. So they're both items, but they tell me clearly that some items are loanable and some items are not.
Okay.
Okay? And then I'm simply going to put book and audio video material as subclasses of loanable items, and reference book and magazine as subclasses of non-loanable item. So if we look at this diagram now, it is pretty clear what is loanable and what is not. And it's actually is a very clean, much cleaner design.
And I see you've gotten rid of the loanable attribute too.
I did, because at this point, this is already represented by the fact of having these two classes. And actually, something else that I did is that I moved all these attributes, value, due date, renewed, and checked out, that makes sense only for loanable item, from item to loanable item. So at this point, this really is telling me that, you know, these characteristics are just meaningful for the loanable item and not for the other ones.
Well, speaking of that, the way that you've got the lines going in the diagram here is you still have request and checked out going to item, even though you can't request non-loadable items. You can't check out non-loadable items.
You're right, actually. You got me on that one. You're exactly right. So these associations are between the two wrong classes. So I guess at this point, you can probably go and fix the diagram yourself.
Well, can we just make the lines go from patron to loanable item instead of to item?
That's exactly the way in which we're going to fix it. So we're going to move these two associations down here. And at this point, this will represent the right relationships in the diagram and in the system.
Makes sense to me.